Welcome back to another FNA, and today is part 4 of my demo reel series. And today we're going to talk about the presentation of your demo reels online and in real life. That sounds so dramatic, in real life. In real life meaning that if you go to something like CTN or SIGGRAPH or something, how would you present your reel? What are the things you should look out for as you share your reel? And lots of other things, but I have a list here, so let's start right away. So right off the bat, where should you put your reel online? Probably YouTube or Vimeo. A lot of people put that on Vimeo. Some people put it on YouTube, but Vimeo seems to be the dominant platform when it comes to demo reels. That being said, you might also have your own website or maybe a blog, or there are many, many sites where you can sign up for free and post your things on there. So there's not really a financial burden to put your reel online. That being said, if you have a website, make the website easy to find and easy to share and easy to browse. Just the main thing is easy. So if you can, not a crazy long web address with numbers and all kinds of things. And that's why something like, again, like Vimeo or YouTube, which is, that's your blink there. But if you do have a blog, just keep that name fairly simple. Now, if you have your own domain, that costs money, but you can have your own name in there. I mean, it's whatever you want to do, whatever works for you financially, but at least keep it simple. So it's just easy to find and easy to go through. At least nowadays, flash websites are not really a thing anymore. But if you do have a flash website, please make sure that you have another way of getting to your demo reel. Because flash websites, you just, it goes through and has crazy animations and not a direct link. It's just very cumbersome to browse and to find something, especially to share. Because the main thing is that if I go online and I find a reel, well, this is really cool, want to send that to supervisors or recruiters, I need to have a direct link that I can send off. If they have to then go through all kinds of hurdles to get to that reel, that's a problem. Those are all hurdles and potential pitfalls and just moments where someone goes, ah, don't have time for this, let me find someone else. So you don't want to do that. You want your work to be as easily accessible, if that's English, to get to without any type of fluff or any type of hurdles. That being said, you might have a reel on there that is not for public consumption. Not that you should have things on your reel that are not cleared by the company, the client, or whatever you work for, but sometimes it's just something that only the company should see, that you're the company you're applying for. So Vimeo has a password protection to enter site. So if you have a reel behind a Vimeo password, that's okay too, but I would recommend to keep that password fairly simple, like your name or demo reel or whatever. But now everybody goes in there and checks that. But you know, something simple for the recruiter, whoever's going to take a look at it, to just go, oh, okay, I get it, and remember it at least. Kind of talked about that before, but once you have your reel online and you present that online, you should have a title card and then your work and then a longer title card at the end. Meaning that at the beginning, you have your name and title, so whoever watches this knows what you're applying for, and then presumably it's going to be animation. So you might have your card with your name and the title, but also responsible for all character animation on this reel. This would be the easiest thing, so that when you watch this, you go, okay, this is all this person. Now, if you do share things, as we talked about before, you can gray things out, you can have subtitles, you can kind of point people towards the things that you did, but all should be servicing the main goal of make it easy to understand and to see and to share, as always. So a short card at the beginning, because you just want to get straight to your work, then you see your work, and at the end card would be longer with your name and then contact of either phone or email, whatever you have, but don't keep that card short, because if someone goes, oh, that was really cool, let me just take notes, if they take notes by hand or whatever, you know, you don't want your reel to suddenly stop and then they got to fumble and restart and whatever. You never know. Just make it as easy as possible. So once the reel is done, the long card, 10, 15, 20 seconds of your title, I mean, it's maybe 20 seconds, a bit long, but longer than the beginning, so maybe 10 seconds, so people can look at it and write it down and remember your name and your contact information. And just to throw it out there, keep your reel short, 1 minute, maybe 2 minutes, don't go longer. There's no need to see that much of your work. Now, going back, so if you have your reel on a website, let's pretend it's even on YouTube, you still have descriptions on YouTube where you can put in links or other things. So if possible, you would have obviously your reel, but then you would have a resume, you would have a reel breakdown, and maybe even a cover letter. Then again, the cover letter should probably be tailored towards the company that you're applying for, to English. So cover letters, not super sure. I would probably just keep that to the application itself. So when you apply, you can upload your cover letter, but at least online, I would have your resume and the demo reel breakdown, meaning that you can exactly explain what you did in the shot. If you did everything, just the foreground, just the background, what was mocap, what was keyframe, whatever you need to explain, you don't want to color all that stuff on the reel when you watch it. So a demo reel breakdown or a shot list or whatever you want to call it, that should be there on your site as well. So if it's on YouTube, in the description, a link to Google Doc, whatever you have, Or if you have an actual website or a blog, then you can have a link to a PDF and so on. And if you do have a link to your movie file of the reel, so be like a MP4, whatever it is, just make sure it's a good codec that works on all kinds of machines, not something fancy that if you download this on the machine, it won't play. So again, it needs to be tested and be able to be seen by as many people as possible and in the easiest way. You don't want someone to go, doesn't work for me, wait, I gotta go online, find this codec, install, okay, no one's gonna do that, no one has the time. So these are the basics for me when you are online. So a website, Vimeo, YouTube, you know, resume, shortlist, everything should be on there accessible for the recruiters, whoever needs to have more information about your work. Now, when you are in real life, when you go to CTN or FMX or GDC, I don't know, wherever you are, and you present your work, it could be either on a laptop or it could be on an iPhone or iPad. Laptops can be big and cumbersome to hold. iPhones could be a bit too small. Probably iPads or just tablets like that would be ideal in terms of presentation because it's just easy to hold and to present. And it just, again, you don't have to worry about, you know, just cumbersome thing holding. Maybe the person watching this can't and you're holding this. You've been there for 10 hours and you can't hold this. I don't know, just make it as easy as possible. And I feel like tablets would be the best thing. That being said, if you do have it on a phone and you might have a bigger phone and you present that, make sure that you turn off notifications. You don't want someone to watch your reel and then have text messages come in with, hey man, yesterday's party was sick and we were so drunk and we did this and we did that. No, or you have some whatever confidential information or your boyfriend, girlfriend, wife texting you things that only you should see. Just make sure that when the person watches your reel, he or she is not interrupted by whatever. They can just take that and watch your reel and be impressed by your work. So turn off notifications. Your reel might also need sound. So what I would recommend is to have over-the-ear headphones. You don't want to give earbuds to someone watching your reel because they're going to look at this and go, so some people don't want to put earbuds into their own ears at all because it's gross, even though you might be clean. But if you're not clean and someone takes the earbuds and looks at this and it's just yellow and it's just gross, like you don't want to put that in your ear. So if you need sound, they need someone to really listen to the sound because it's lip sync or whatever and whatever SIGGRAPH or whatever you are, it's loud and they can't hear it. And you want to provide headphones. Do at least over-the-ear headphones, even if it's just those small ones. It doesn't have to be the whole big ones, but something that's easy to put on and not gross. Now, while the person watches your reel, watch the person, read the person. You're an animator, you're supposed to pick up on body language, stuff like that. So watch that person, and then you can see, are they invested? Are they interested? Are they kind of looking and distracted, looking at something else? And all of that will give you some sort of, hopefully, enough indication of, can I then ask about my reel? Can I push the person to tell me more about the reel? So just if someone is distracted or in a hurry and you feel like that person is not gonna have time to talk to me about the reel and just kind of looking at it, the worst case scenario, like I mentioned last time, just ask, what is the worst shot on the reel? So you say, hey, thanks for looking at it. I know you're busy. Can you just tell me what's the worst shot or what are the worst shots and tell me what I should cut out? And then the person can just say this, this, and this, or maybe nothing, which would be obviously the perfect thing. And then that's it. And that person is free to go somewhere else. But in the event that the person does have time to talk to you, then talk about the shots and you can talk about what needs more improvement, more work, something you need to replace and so on. But even if the conversation goes well, I would not at the end go, okay, that's cool. So can you hire me? Can you give me a job? So just be careful how much you push. If the work is really good, chances are the person's going to say, okay, give me your contact information, update your reel. And when it's done, send it to me. I'll send it to the recruiters. Or your reel is awesome. It's great. Go talk to recruiter or I talk to recruiter, whatever it is. But if it's good enough, chances are the person looking at your reel is going to tell you that they will initiate some sort of beginning process of talking to HR and the hiring person involved at that company. If the reel is not good and you start pushing, hey, can you give me a job? It's just going to be uncomfortable and weird and who knows how that interaction is going to continue. So if the person doesn't ask you for more, then maybe you should not push. So read the person and maybe you can ask, so now that you've seen this, do you know maybe when you might be hiring in the future so I can update my reel and send it to your company? Maybe then you can have a little bit of discussion like that. But I wouldn't go immediately and push for, hey, hire me and give me that job if the person isn't right away telling you, this is really cool, you should work for us, that type of thing. But this is a longer discussion, all comes down to your expectations too. And that is actually going to be part 5, demo reel expectations, what you should think about, what you should expect. Will you work at a bigger company right away, at a smaller company, all those expectations, that is a big subject for part 5. So there you go. This is my general overview of your demo reel presentation online or in real life. If you have any other experiences with that and you want to add something to this of what you did did and maybe the pitfalls or negative or positive things that happened to you as you presented your reel, be it again online or at a conference or wherever it is. Comments are open. As always, let me know. Share if you can your experiences so other people can learn from that. Other than that, that's it from me. And if you're still watching this, as always, thank you for your patience in watching this. If you feel like you want to see more, subscribe, hit that bell button, because I do upload almost every day, not on the weekends, except today. So subscribe and like if you want to, if you thought that this was helpful at all to you. Either way, I say thank you, and I will see you in my next clip.